Hello, journal. Dear journal. Hi, journal. Hello, stranger. I've been thinking a lot about... My dream is to become a writer. Yeah, right! A writer who can't even write. Okay, find something simple to start with. What did I do today? Today I got up. I had breakfast. I tried watching the telly. That's it. I'm going back to bed. Hi, journal. Another day. Each time I wake up, for the tiniest of moments, it isn't true. But then it all comes rushing back. It is true. Looking around my room, everything reminds me of Gran. Her puzzle box gift from last year. The magic tank we made during the holiday. Our yogurt pot robot. These paints Gran gave me. This pen. Even you, journal. She's everywhere. And all of it feels broken. Today is Ben's birthday. Dad baked a cake. Mum insisted that I come down and have some. Tasted like nothing. Everything does. Mum said we need to send out invitations to the funeral. How can she think about that? She's ready to shove Gran into a box like a pet goldfish. Then I stormed off into my room. Later, Dad came up for some well-meant dad talk.
I know you're sad, but it will get better. You'll see. Just give it time.
I know he wanted to cheer me up, but
he's wrong.
The world feels very dark now. Gran has a proverb for times like these.
Gran always says,
it's always darkest before the dawn.
No, that's not right. That's what she would have said. I keep thinking about all the things Gran won't get to see. When I go to university, she won't be there. When I get my first job, she won't be there. If I get married, she won't be there. Even if that's unlikely because... boys. I prefer cats. Missing Gran already feels so bad. But how could I want that feeling to go away? How could I be fine with Gran being gone? I'm going to have to feel like this forever. Thanks, Pinky. I can't stop crying. Pinky is probably getting fed up with being used as a tissue. But she never leaves my side. I think that means get back to writing your story. Pinky's got a point. I should at least try to write. I can't leave Grace like that. She's as lost as I am.
My head. Where am I?
A grey void surrounded her, swallowing sound and hope.
Hello?
Grace guessed that if she kept moving, then surely a solution would present itself.
Is someone here? Anyone? In the emptiness around her, she found...
a hut? A palace? Hope? I... don't know what comes next.
It's so cold here. So empty. Just nothingness.
I can't find the words. I'm never going to find the dragon. Or the fireflies.
They won't come. The words just won't come anymore.
I don't know where I am, how to get out, or even where I'm going.
Pointless. What kind of writer can't find the words?
I messed everything up. Let's try this again.
Grace awoke under an old tree in an unfamiliar land.
I don't know if I can do this anymore.
She walked boldly ahead, a spring in her step.
I'm so tired.
Grace knew she just had to keep going.
What's the point? Put one foot in front of the other.
I've failed. It's over.
Whilst she still had breath left in her body, there was still hope.
This is all my fault. I should just stop.
Hey, Grace.
Leave me. Just leave me.
Psst. Here.
Where? I don't see a thing.
I'm right here. Always was, always will be.
I don't understand. And I don't care.
You don't?
No. Just leave. I'm meant to be alone. Forever alone and useless.
You know I'm right below you.
I'm not good company right now.
You don't need to be. Why don't you tell me how you came to be here?
It sounds silly when I say it now. I lost a dragon. And now... I just don't know what to do next.
But at some point you knew, right? You had purpose, hope.
Yes. I knew exactly what I needed to do. I had to stop the dragon. Return the fireflies. Save the village.
And you couldn't do those things?
I tried. But I just ended up doing everything wrong.
Everything? Are you sure about that?
Well...
Think back.
Okay. Maybe not everything.
Go on.
I didn't deliberately freeze everyone in the Undersea Kingdom.
Well then, that's something.
I like listening to you. Would you continue?
You do? Oh. Well, okay. It's just...
I feel so weak. I can hardly move.
That's okay.
It's not. People are relying on me.
But you're still human. You still tire. We all do.
It doesn't feel that way. I'm tired. Tired of trying. Tired of failing. Tired of everything.
You need a rest.
But I can't! I don't have time!
Why?
My village is depending on me to get the fireflies back.
That sounds like quite a tiring thing to do.
Well... yes.
Want to take a rest together?
That sounds nice. There's something I want to ask you.
Go on.
It's difficult.
I'll wait.
No idea what to do now. Maybe you could help me find out what to do?
What were you trying to do before you got here?
I was trying to find a dragon. It destroyed everything I loved. I need to get the fireflies back. They'll restore my village. But... I just don't know what I'm doing anymore.
What did you do last time?
Last time I what?
Found a dragon.
What? I've never found one before.
Then how can you expect to know exactly what to do?
I guess I can't. But I want to.
No one ever got anything just by wanting it. You've got to try. You've got to fail sometimes.
I guess so. I want to know one more thing.
You sound a lot better.
I do? I guess I feel better.
Well then, time to set course.
It's nice of you to listen to me.
Anytime. So, anything else?
I don't know where to go.
Yes, that is quite the conundrum.
That's not entirely helpful.
You seem to think that it's wrong to be lost.
Well, isn't it?
Everyone feels a little lost sometimes, even me.
Oh. I'd have never imagined you being lost.
I don't mind it, actually. Do you?
Well... yes. I usually know what to do. And where to go.
So, if someone else were lost, what would you tell them to do?
I tell them not to give up and find help.
How about taking your own advice?
I guess it's easier to give advice than take it. Could you get me someplace else?
Let me see if I can help you out there. Patience. This is where I leave.
But I...
You're not alone. You are loved. Be kind to yourself.
Can I do this?
Yes. Be your own light in the darkness.
I'll try. Thank you. Here we go. Again.